me say that it will take sustained behavior, risk reduction behavior, to maintain these gains. We must continue to wear our mask. We must continue to wash our hands before taking our hands to our face. As a people, we must continue to observe social distancing. Physical contact increases your risk. We must continue to make sure that we, as a people, avoid huge gatherings, because where there are a lot of people, the risk is higher. Remember, all these behaviors reduce your risk of getting COVID-19. It does not mean that once you do these things, the whole world, there is no way you get it. It's about risk reduction, and I encourage all to do that. PPEs. More often than not, we've heard that, oh, there's inadequacy of PPEs here and there. PPEs are consumables. This mask, by 2-3, I might throw it away. I have to get another one. So even if I get a supply of 2-3 boxes, in 3-4 days, I can tell you it's inadequate. All I'm telling you is that it is being used. So you must also keep the supply chain going. And I'm happy to mention that Honorable Kwaku Ajimamenu, together with all partners, including the Foreign Affairs Ministry, are committed to making sure that we continue to restock, resupply all health facilities, as well as all stakeholders who are involved with the management of the fight. There are three sources for PPEs. Either it's public, that is government, private, as in like McDonald, Despite and the rest did, or through partnerships. And I'm happy that this partnership from our embassy in China has resulted in having these numbers. With partnerships, we can win the war faster and quicker. And so I'll take this opportunity to encourage all NGOs, civil society organizations, all agencies, whether public or private, to come on board so that we can sustain the supply chain and make sure that we protect our health workers and protect ourselves as a people.